So yeah, with this match, the fans actually got to pick the stipulation for this one. And obviously, anyone that's been watching DKW will know about the rivalry between Lucas Jackson and Andros J. And essentially, Lucas Jackson got suspended for putting his hands on Vicky, Andros J's manager. And essentially, at Trick or Yeet, we saw Lucas Jackson make his return from suspension. With this match, obviously, the fans got to choose what the stipulation was going to be.
We're about to find out what match the fans picked. Before we do that, though, let me just explain what the options were. One of them was a steel chairs match. Let's just say Lucas Jackson has plenty of experience with steel chairs. The second option was a lumberjack match. For those of you that don't know, the ring will be surrounded by members of the DKW roster to make sure that neither Lucas nor Andros leave the ring during the match. The final option was a Falls Count Anywhere match. Anything goes, no disqualification, and you can pin or submit your opponent anywhere in the venue or even outside of the venue. So I'm going to just stop talking now because I want to know what the fans picked. So let's find out.
So this match was the match that the fans decided the stipulation for. So let's first see what that stipulation is. So you guys have the opportunity to vote on a steel chairs match, a lumberjack match, or a Falls Count Anywhere. So, this match will be, drum roll please, Leigh, come on. You guys are going to be brawling all through this building. Who knows where they're going to end up? So let's get the first of the two participants out. Introducing first, the life coach, Lucas Jackson.
So here we have a man who has run riot on DKW since day one of getting here. I'm not sure if you're aware, but he has essentially made Andros' career in DKW a living nightmare.
Yeah, for some reason, the life coach has taken a dislike to Andros J. Maybe it's the red hair. Who knows? But yeah, I mean, what's he doing here? Is he looking for something under the ring, or is he just trying to hide, or what?
I'm putting my money on a steel chair.
Wouldn't surprise me.
He's still looking for it. Yvette, we have plenty of stuff under that ring. He's spoiled for choice.
And the thing is, knowing what was under there, you saw how quickly I got out of that ring there as well. So I don't want to be any part of this. I'm just there to announce the winner. And it is Andros J coming to the ring.
Oh, and Lucas Jackson getting the jump on Andros J. Why am I not surprised? Why am I not surprised that somehow...
One, two.
Wow, that was a quick pin attempt there. But
remember,
why am I not surprised that the life coach somehow found a way to cheat in a no DQ match?
You got to think, there's no such thing as cheating in a no disqualification match because everything is legal.
There may be no such thing as necessarily cheating, but there are certain moral aspects.
Oh, straight into the wall there. And you got to think, these two, as we've seen, they could pin each other out here in the crowd. They could go down to Leon C Beach and pin each other if they want. They could go along the high street and pin each other.
They could go to my favourite place, a coffee shop, and pin each other.
They could indeed. As long as Alex Davenport is there with them, as long as a camera is there with them, then anything goes here. And these two just brawling straight out in front of the fans here.
And don't forget, this is a no DQ match. So they could pick up any item from anywhere they go and use it.
Like, You see a lady in the front row with a walking stick. They could pick that up and hit each other with it. There's stuff on, you can see on the merchandise table, they could pick stuff up from there.
Personally, if I was going to use something from the merch table, it wouldn't be a foam finger.
Well, finger poke of doom.
Oh! The midsection of Lucas Jackson going right into that steel beam of the apron. Two count there. Considering the feud these guys have going on, I wouldn't be surprised if they took their time with this match. Just to inflict that little bit extra punishment.
Andros J there asking the fans, do they want a kendo stick? And Julie, Andros J obliges. You see Vicky watching on there at ringside.
Oh! You can hear Lucas Jackson screaming in pain as he is struck by that kendo stick.
There is no giving that kendo stick whatsoever. I felt that thing before the match. There is no giving that at all.
Oh, right on the shoulder blade there.
Remember, kids watching this, do not try this stuff at home. These guys are trained athletes. They know exactly what they are doing here.
Oh, running forearm there, going for another one.
Life coach there just raking the face of Andros J. Going for
a camel clutch here.
Camel clutch.
Andros J just going limp after that. Oh, and well, there goes his left arm. Lucas Jackson choosing not to use the kendo stick. That's peculiar. What else has he got planned? Oh, a big leg drop there.
Dropping a weapon of his own, and that being that big leg of Lucas Jackson straight across Andros J. Is he looking for Old Faithful, that steel chair? Looking for something.
There it is. That he used to almost win the DKW British Championship. Oh, boot there.
Andros J scouted that steel chair attempt, coming off the apron there and back brawling in front of the DKW crowd here. Remember, guys, this is Falls Count Anywhere. So if Andros J was to go for a pinfall in the crowd here, it would count.
If he got it.
Yeah, there's two different things, going for a pinfall and actually getting a pinfall. So, Lucas Jackson just back on the offensive here.
Oh, and here comes that steel chair across the windpipe there.
Again, there is no give in these chairs whatsoever.
Oh, nothing but frame there. The hardest part of the chair.
You got to think, what must be going through the mind of Vicky watching on at ringside, seemingly helpless, but...
Oh, Andros J attempting a rope break there, but there are no rope breaks in a Falls Count Anywhere match.
Yeah, going back to what I was just saying, like, with Vicky watching on at ringside here, you know, obviously Lucas Jackson put his hands on her before. What is going through her head watching her tag team partner just get demolished?
Through my head is, when do I get to take a swing at Lucas Jackson?
To be honest, I think that is going to be the thoughts of probably 95% of this DKW locker room, to be honest.
And probably the DKW venue.
And probably most of the people that are sitting watching this match in the crowd and watching it at home as well. What's Andros J thinking here?
He's thinking, let's not hit my head in this lie. Oh, a massive elbow drop there. Oh, Lucas Jackson. Where did that chain come from? Pulled it from thin air and just nailed Andros J in the gut.
It looked like he had it wrapped. Looked like he'd planted it, like wrapped it around the pole, the post of the ring, and
hidden in plain sight. I'll give you that much. As you know, Lucas Jackson, no stranger to this kind of environment. We'll throw it back a little bit. Last week, we had Vinny Daniels on commentary. Vinny Daniels knows so much about Lucas Jackson and his many, many hardcore and no DQ matches with him.
Lucas Jackson, with that chain, it's a solid metal chain straight across the throat of Andros J there. And you mentioned Vinny Daniels. He, oh, nasty blow there from Lucas Jackson. But Vinny Daniels actually teaming with Lucas Jackson and Taylor James at the last event in this building at New Independence Day against Andros J and the Brotherhood.
Oh, across the back. Well, I suppose the truings say, keep your friends close and your enemies closer.
And Lucas Jackson setting up the chairs. You want to sit down mid-match?
How about we have an in-match interview with Andros J? How's it going, Andros? Was the wire decision today coming? Was it? Oh.
We tried that mid-match interview, but the pace set of Andros J obviously not taken too kindly for it and gets a steel chair across his throat for the trouble, for his troubles.
Oh, headbutt there from Lucas Jackson just drops Andros J.
Is he looking for something else now?
I would not put it past him.
What else is under that ring? Oh, it's another steel chair. How many more does he want?
As many as he put there. Boot to the chest there.
You've got to think as well, this ring is getting super dangerous with two chairs, steel chain, a kendo stick.
A Lucas Jackson
as well, yeah.
On the topic of Lucas Jackson and steel chairs, what contraption is he building there?
It's a contraption that's going to hurt both himself and Andros J if he nails this.
Uh-oh. Oh, and he misses. Knee and head first on each chair there.
And Andros J has got to capitalize now, surely. Turns round.
Oh,
big lariat.
But more like he connected with his elbow. Referee Alex Davenport just rearranging the furniture there.
He's keeping him in the ring, but he's keeping him at a safe distance, shall we say.
Probably making sure he doesn't trip over them. That's the last thing we need. Oh, big boot there.
Going for the twist of fate.
Oh, he gets all of it. One, two. The life coach kicks out of that one. A very near fall there. The crowd pleading with Andros J to give him another one. Oh, and he delivers. Another near fall.
You're going for that tornado DDT, that signature move of Andros J. Setting up a couple of steel chairs here. He wants to inflict as much damage with this move as he possibly can. Andros J wants to end this match now.
Oh, going for it. Oh, and he gets all of it.
This is it, surely. This is
the life coach spiked on top of those steel chairs on the top of his head. One, two. How did he kick out?
Veteran instincts there from Lucas Jackson. How did he kick out? You and me are both
veteran instincts? Are you insane? Even a veteran wouldn't kick out of that. That is nothing but resolve. Andros J putting the chair across the back of Lucas Jackson with every ounce of his force.
Seems like this is just born more out of frustration than anything else, what Andros J is doing at the moment.
After what the life coach has done to him, I'd consider this frustration as well. I'd be frustrated. Lucas Jackson just reaching out for anything that he can get. Oh, did you see that chair bend across the shoulders?
I've honestly lost count of how many chair shots this has been now. Lucas Jackson is just pleading. But
hold on, Vicky, what are you doing? Oh, what?
What am I seeing here? Vicky,
I'm sorry. What did we just witness? The life changer on the steel chair after the interference from Vicky, and the life coach won.
Vicky telling Andros J there to remember his values.
Where are hers?
Hitting him in the gut with a steel chair and allowing Lucas Jackson to get the victory.
And now raising his hand. Hang on. She removing her Andros J t-shirt. What did we just witness?
So does this mean now that Vicky is part of the life coach program?
I guess. I don't know. Whatever it is, I'm not happy with it. Now what does Andros do?
Back to the drawing board, I suppose. And, you know, he's going to have all these fans behind him.